Anh chưa.
The President, please be seated. The chamber is now back in session. The chamber would like now to give the opportunity again to Madame Chun Navi to continue her statement. And please make your statement relevant to the facts at S21 and the facts related to your husband, the and the damages and sufferings as a result of those facts, as well as the death of your husband. Civil Party, I am here again. I'm Chhin. Good afternoon, Your Honours, ladies and gentlemen.
Mesdames, Messieurs les juges, Mesdames, Messieurs. Je reprends donc, je m'appelle.
Regarding my application as a civil party, for my husband, T. Hao Taik, the deputy chairman of civil aviation in Fukintong, when the Pol Pot regime fell, I worked at the 7th January Hospital or the Chinese Hospital, but now a 42-story building is being constructed.
Et actuellement, on est en train d'y construire un bâtiment de 42 étages.
Between 78 and 80, the Ministry of
80,
Health,
le ministère de la Santé,
informs the director of the 7th January Hospital, and subsequently he told all the staff of the hospital that the ministry permitted us to visit the genocidal museum of Dulles Lang. At that time, I haven't heard the word S21. When all the staff were taken to visit the museum, and there were roughly 50 or 60 of us all together.
Nous étions une cinquantaine,
it was still in the beginning.
C'était encore au début.
Anybody could just come and ask for a job because in order to survive,
et n'importe qui pouvait
despite
venir
their
un travail,
lack of technical or professional capability,
de personnel.
At Dulles Lang, I met the people who worked there, and one person told me that he was a former Dulles Lang prisoner. He presented himself as Ung Eng Pek.
Il s'est présenté sous le nom de Ung Pek.
And after the fall of Phnom Penh, he was allowed to work in that location. He made a presentation for our group, as I said, of what happened in 75, 76, and 77. And then he asked his staff to guide us through the cells at the south, and on the portable loudspeaker, the presenter told us that in that cell, the person was accused to be a CIA agent, and he was handcuffed and shackled on both feet, and for torture treatment, a rake was used to rake on his face, and blood and flesh was spattered around.
Il avait été torturé, notamment
and
au visage,
it was evident that the blood stain was there on the floor. Encore, and when the person died, he was moved. And the mat of his body was still apparent on the floor.
Traîné dehors et m'envoyait encore la trace sur le sol.
at that time, I recalled the time that my elder sister made a sound to the militia at the village when the militia asked about the profession of my husband. So at that time, I had a feeling that he died in that location. After we visited those individual cells and rooms, we came back to the reception area, and Mr. Ng Bait told us, as I told the chamber, that there were surviving documents, and amongst those documents, I saw a document of the arrest of Ti Hao Tek taken from Sector 25. The date of the arrest is 22nd of February 76, and the date of smash is May 76. I could imagine that he was tortured, and when I saw the date of entry and the date of smashing, I could not imagine anything else. I was shocked, desperate. I was speechless. In my mind, I was like a dead person. I was almost unconscious, but I did not want them to carry me. And I tried to be strong. And then I requested the document, and I received a document with the same information as I was shown. When I saw the photo, I was speechless.
Quand j'ai vu la photo, j'en ai encore été muette d'émotion.
I had been suffering from this for so many years, and it's still happening to me.
Cette photo me fait le même effet.
I cried a lot. When I returned home that afternoon,
I kept crying. Je ne pouvais m'empêcher de pleurer.
Just kept crying. And next day, when I came to work, I kept crying again.
Au travail, je continuais à pleurer.
I told my colleagues that my husband's photo was displayed at the museum,
se trouvait au musée,
and that he was smashed there.
Et qu'il avait été tué là.
A colleague comforted me, and that I should not cry because then my husband already passed away, and then his life was over from this world,
et que lui n'aurait plus à souffrir en ce
and
monde
that
monde.
We, or I, should be focusing on taking care of my children.
Sur l'éducation de mes enfants.
Everybody was trying to comfort me at the time.
Essayait de me consoler.
And later on, my tear seemed to stop flowing. I still can remember her words that she told me to try to forget what happened. She told me that she wants to study in Germany and that I should only think of the prosperous future time and forget of what happened in the past. But in my mind, I still vividly imagines the torture act, the suffering inflicted upon my husband,
souffrance infligée à mon mari.
And he was arrested, interrogated to extract confession. He was compelled to confess. He was tortured to confess. And I want to research for that document, but in my heart I was so weak, and I would feel that I would be fainted when I see such a document. I want Dutch to respond to me that such a document exists, so that the case file for my husband is complete.
Pour que l'on puisse compléter le dossier de mon mari ici au procès.
In my mind now, maybe I think it's better for me to make a film.
et peut-être
of what I learned and the fate of my husband for my children to see in the future for the next Cambodian generation, for everybody to see the suffering and the cruel act committed by that regime. Importantly, we felt betrayed. Especially my elder sister, she was doctrinated, that's why she said such a thing.
C'est pour ça qu'elle a dit ce genre de choses.
I asked her about what a communist was, but now, through such suffering and experience, I understood what a communism was. That is the act of jealousy, of competition, of killing, of taking people to tool slang, of betraying, of reporting the in-law to be arrested and executed. Even now, I look after her children. I helped her children. I'm sorry, Mr. President, although this one is not directly related to tool slang, but probably I keep bursting out regarding my elder sister.
Et je vous parle beaucoup, sans doute, de ma sœur
aînée. A Singaporean media came to interview me the other day and asked whether I was still angry with my sister, and I told them, no, I stopped.
Non.
Being angry with her.
Je suis plus en colère aujourd'hui contre ma sœur.
But they said they were angry on my behalf. And I said, that's okay, it's common, we live in this world. And you are entitled to your feeling.
Chacun a le droit.
And when I learned the Buddhist praying, the Buddhist theory in disciplines,
I
have been feeling a bit calmer. And I understand that what it did was because of the ideology of the communism that was doctrinated upon her.
Qui lui a été imposé par les communistes.
And actually, after she reported my husband, I blamed her. Maybe she wanted to be a wife of Pol Pot. That's why she said such a thing to the militiaman. And how come she was so cruel? And sometimes when I see the faces of people, I just hate it.
Des gens. J'avais de la haine.
My feeling of anger seems to
mon sentiment de colère.
Be lessened through my Buddhist learning. And also, I heard the policy of reconciliation by the government and to find justice for the victims. I was asking myself, at what level justice can be found for the victims?
À quel niveau peut-on trouver et rendre justice aux victimes?
The national government and the international
participation
together work hand in hand to find justice and to satisfy with such feeling, I felt relieved. But here I am still keep watching. It is not my habit to lie to people.
Ici, je vous dis la vérité.
It is not my habit at all to fabricate anybody or to trick anybody. And that's why I was so upset when my elder sister betrayed us.
En colère vis-à-vis de ma sœur parce que elle
but
m'a
maybe
trahi.
What she did at the time was for her own goal.
À ce moment-là,
and as we said, when she
planned
chili, then she would get chili. And if she, whatever
chili,
she grows, then she would get that own fruit. So the result would
tout,
fall upon her. And
donc,
here I am sitting before the president, before your honor,
si
to find justice for my relatives,
actes,
for all Cambodian people. We are all relatives, regardless of families we are attached to.
Les uns les autres, nous, au Cambodge.
I don't want to be dragging, but this is also a principle of
Bouddhism. Sur ce sujet, mais c'est également un principe
If you look at Buddha, he used to be reincarnated in different
Bouddha,
forms.
Lui était réincarné dans différentes
formes. And I actually wanted to tell Dutch. Actually, I have a pity on Dutch.
Effectivement, moi, Duke me fait pitié.
Because in this world, maybe when I have a pity on Dutch, maybe people would get offended because this is a world of human beings, not a sacred world. And he deserves what he did. And like my sister, she deserved what he did when she reported my husband to the militia. If I did not study Buddhist discipline, then the anger would still be burning in my heart. So I should not get offended for what people do for their own good or for their own benefit.
On récolte ce qu'on
sème. The feeling of suffering, of course, is indescribable.
C'est indescriptible.
Like in the case of the civil party, the French woman whose husband died at Dulslein, everybody suffered, and the pain we have. And the international judge asked, whether any Westerners were detained at Dulslein. And of course, probably talk about that Briton. If you look at the New Zealander, he felt the suffering, and it was only his brother. But if you look at my case, it's my husband. And that I also have to look after my children. You can consider that, how much suffering I have been
m'occuper de mes enfants, malgré la souffrance que j'ai ressentie.
However, as I repeatedly said, the suffering
comme je l'ai dit maintes et maintes
was
fois,
tremendous.
Cette souffrance
and if I keep talking, I would have never been able to stop.
Et je pourrais continuer à parler.
And in short, the suffering is the same.
Pendant des
when
heures
you suffer, you
bref,
suffer.
La souffrance est la même.
And how could I compensate for the suffering that I have been that received?
That is,
how
que j'ai enduré,
the truth can be revealed to
comment
me?
I suffered.
I lost all the
moi,
property.
J'ai perdu
in the previous regime, I tried not to spend much. I tried to build my property, to build a house.
Économe,
but in the end, we were victimized.
Et en fin de compte, nous avons
I was detained at a
système.
Office M15.
Détenu au centre M15.
But I was like stuck in the middle.
Et j'étais
and if I go home, and when I hear
lorsque
about the testimony in the chamber, then I would cry, and then my eyes would dry, and I would find it hard not to use teardrop or eye drop. And with my current living condition, it is difficult for me to afford such relief medication. People with great attitude, with morality, try to be a good person to serve the nation,
nous essayons d'être des gens de
a person
moralité,
who
de
was
mœurs,
so innocent and did not involved in politics and why he was being treated that way, in a cruel way and smashed. Nothing could be able to compensate
rien
for such act committed by that regime upon my husband. Nothing at all.
Subi.
And here we talk about
Marie.
The widows.
Si nous parlons des veuves.
We were suffering in various forms, at various
notre
levels.
Notre souffrance prenait différentes formes.
Some widows, because of their bad habits of gambling, their husbands divorced them. But look at me, I was loyal to my nation, I was loyal to my husband,
moi,
and we served the nation
moi,
together, and how come
mari,
I was punished that way,
nation,
and then my husband was taken away from me.
J'étais puni de cette manière-là, et mon mari a été emmené.
Madame Civil Party, I think it is sufficient for the chamber now to hear your story, and maybe it's a good idea for other parties to put questions or observations regarding the death of your husband.
Pour que les parties civiles puissent vous poser, pour que
and
l'ensemble des parties puissent vous
like
poser des questions sur votre témoignage. La chambre souhaiterait
civil party lawyer who is representing this civil party, you can put further questions to clarify the matter that you wished in support of her application to be a civil party to this case. The chamber would also like to remind the civil party lawyer that the questions so it'll be easy for her to understand.
À vous poser des questions complémentaires,
so
en
that
précisant
her
response que ces questions doivent être courtes
is appropriate.
Et doivent être posées de manière à ce qu'il vous soit facile d'y répondre. Ces questions doivent être claires.
Civil Party lawyer. Thank you, Mr. President, and thank you for
Président.
The opportunity for me to ask
vous remercie de me
my client
de poser des questions complémentaires.
Madame Chenavi, can I ask
Madame
you some questions?
Madame Chenavi, puis-je vous poser quelques questions?
Response, yes.
Réponse,
go
oui.
Ahead.
Allez-y.
Counsel.
Question.
Madame Chenavi, what year
Madame
were you born?
Chumnavi. Madame Chenavi, en quelle année êtes-vous née?
Response. I was born in 1939.
Je suis né en 1939.
Question. Can you tell us in your ID?
Selon vous.
It shows that you were born in 1946. Why there is such
votre
discrepancy?
Votre pièce d'identité indique que vous êtes né en 1946. Comment pouvez-vous expliquer cette incohérence?
Actually, after my ID was made, I did not pay much attention to the details.
Je n'ai pas porté une attention particulière aux informations contenues dans cette pièce d'identité.
Arise because the new ID was done later during the election.
La nouvelle carte d'identité a été faite plus tard au moment
des élections. It was done by the SANCAT, and the information was put in by them.
Qui a émis ces documents et c'est eux qui ont saisi ces informations.
I thought maybe when I reach my retirement age and if I still have strength to
si
do
la
to work,
force de le faire, si j'ai encore la force de travailler,
then probably I could work a few more years by reducing my age. So I don't want to lie.
De plus,
that's why it's a bit different from my
donc c'est la raison pour laquelle il y a une différence entre ma date de naissance réelle et ma date de naissance figurant dans cette pièce d'identité.
You were born in 1939. Is that correct?
Question. Est-ce exact que vous dire
yes,
qu'en fait vous êtes né en 1939?
Question.
Réponse oui, c'est exact. Question.
You told the court that
vous avez dit au tribunal, vous avez dit à la chambre.
You obtained the information in relation to the death of your husband, Mr. Tia Hao Tuck at
S21
office. When did you actually obtain this information?
Quand avez-vous effectivement obtenu ces informations?
Response.
Ma réponse.
I got this information in 1980.
En 1980.
Because the workers at the hospital were invited to pay a visit to the compound.
De l'hôpital ont été invités à
Council, thank you.
Se rendre dans
when
le
you
complexe
received
de S21.
This information
question
and learned that your husband was executed at S21, how was your feeling back?
Qu'est-ce que vous
then?
Avez ressenti au moment où vous avez appris que votre mari avait été emmené exécuté à S21? À l'époque, au moment où vous avez appris la nouvelle.
Response.
Réponse.
When I learned that
lorsque
he was killed at S21 by torture.
Tué sous la torture S21.
And he experienced some kind of very harsh tortures. I was so moved and
en voyant la gravité
I
des tortures que j'ai subies, j'étais bouleversé. J'ai perdu connaissance.
Coming to help me.
Et les gens sont venus me porter secours.
And from then I told myself
et
that
ce
it
je
was
me suis dit que
I alone who had to struggle
je devais
to hold on to life
m'accrocher.
And that
I
had no
for
more husband to assist
et je
me and I was very sympathetic to my husband who was
et
a good person but was tortured and interrogated and had to confess to
torturé,
the
emprisonné, torturé,
confession in the confession which was obtained under tortures.
Et ses aveux ont été obtenus sous la torture.
And I cannot revisit Tuol's Lang Museum because the memory haunts me and makes me sick.
Et me rend malade.
As a widow,
en tant que veuve,
after my husband died, I have nothing left much in my life to live on.
Pas grand chose
but
dans la vie. Pour m'accrocher
I
à la vie
still
et continuer.
Have had children,
mais il me restait mes enfants.
I had to really raise them, but raising children without the presence of a husband would not be easy.
D'un mari à ses côtés, ce n'est pas quelque chose de facile.
I can't stop thinking of the moment,
moment
I witnessed at S21 in relation to
vu ce que j'ai vu à
the death of my husband. Any moment I recall the event, then I am so tearful and I had to have some medicines to calm me down.
Compisai, thank you.
With Mr. President's leave, may the photo of her husband be put up on display.
Question, Monsieur le Président, pourrait-on
the President, the court official, is now instructed to
projeter
put
the
photo
du mari
of her husband
de la partie civile. Le
on
président,
the projector.
Je demande à l'huissier de bien vouloir installer la photographie de manière à ce que nous puissions la voir grâce à votre projecteur.
Mr. Compisai.
Question de Maître Compisai.
Mrs. Chinnavi, can you recognize
Madame
this photo?
Chinnavi, pouvez-vous reconnaître la personne sur cette
response.
Photo? Réponse. Réponse.
He is my husband.
C'est mon mari.
If you look at his eyes,
si regardez son regard,
look at his eyebrows,
regardez ses
sourcils. Was weird by tortures.
On peut voir qu'il porte des traces de torture. Son visage
was different. He was different et from the very previous photo
et déformé par rapport aux photos précédentes.
Question, where did you obtain this photo from?
D'où tenez-vous cette photographie?
Réponse. I got it from Tuol Slang.
Je l'ai obtenu de la prison de Tuol Slang.
S21 office.
Connu également sous le nom de centre.
I have also obtained the list.
J'ai également obtenu la liste des prisonniers.
List of incoming and outgoing
et les prisonniers sortants.
And my colleague actually who worked at the hospital also conducted research on this information.
Mr. Bisay, Mr.
President Liu, I would like document ERN 0
avec votre permission
0
qu'on affiche 0 8 document
0 6
0 0
4 0 be put up on display
0 0 80.
The President, the AV unit is now instructed to put document 0 0 8 0 640 on the screen.
Je demande à ce que le document figurant à la code 0080640 soit affiché à l'écran.
Mr.
Question.
Compisai, thank you. This document is the list of the victims
who were
detained at S21. This document is obtained from DCCAM.
If
we look at line 15 from the top of the page,
à partir du haut de la page, la ligne 15.
Madame Chenavi, can you read this writing, Chinavi, whether you're familiar with this
écriture,
name?
Pouvez-vous nous dire si vous connaissez le nom de cette personne?
Response. It is my husband's name.
Il s'agit bien du nom de mon mari.
Tia Hao Tak. Who was detained from
détenu.
Office, correction, sector 25.
Qui,
I have not had my glasses on, but I still can read this line that my husband was entering the facility at
de l'entrée de mon
on the 22nd of February 1976.
S21.
Mr. Pisay, thank you, Mr.
Question.
President. Could you please instruct the AV to remove this document,
please?
Next, Madame Chenavi, could you please be brief? Could you tell the court the life of a widow and without the presence of your husband?
How difficult
has this been for you?
Pouvez-vous nous parler de la difficulté de votre existence, étant donné ces circonstances? Réponse.
Whose husband
que veuve dont le mari
was killed,
a été éliminé.
I maintained a position. The stands that I left my home village, that I had to be strong
to help raise
my children to become good people,
pour qu'ils deviennent
to the best of my ability.
Des personnes
and
bonnes.
Then I
et
found them the place where they can settle down. And nothing left for me. I had to start from scratch with bare hands.
De zéro, avec mes mains nues.
And I was so worried that I could probably, I felt I could not probably raise the children.
J'étais très inquiète de ne pas arriver à élever mes enfants.
And I was so worried that my children could die because I could not feed them.
Une autre source d'inquiétude pour moi, c'était la peur que mes enfants meurent faute de ne pas arriver à les nourrir.
I wouldn't allow with other people to really collect the ammunition or the kind of DDT powder so that I can really sell to the scrap collector.
Se vendre ces
at that time Cambodian currency were not yet produced
and we could
make use of the Vietnamese currency.
Et on utilisait and there was
no plate, no pot. It was
so il n'y avait pas de casserole, il n'y avait pas d'assiette.
We
on vivait
were left
avec très peu de choses.
Empty-handed.
Il ne nous restait rien.
And I had to walk places
et j'ai dû
to
travailler dans
collect
différents endroits.
Anything I could
aller chercher
get,
tout ce que je pouvais,
to the,
n'importe quoi, pour pouvoir
rubbish collector,
vendre
to the,
cela à des,
people who could really
des gens qui pouvaient acheter,
these,
échanger
and it was so desperate.
Ce que je
and
pouvais
I
trouver
had to struggle to hold on to life
et
and so that my children could become a person who
are
good people and can be government employees in some ministries.
Et des personnes pouvant être employées dans les ministères, devenir
fonctionnaires.
Question. Je souhaiterais vous poser une question, si je peux vous inviter simplement.
Have you had have you paid a visit
bref.
To any hospital or to the psychiatrist to have your mental fitness?
Ou avez-vous consulté un psychiatre?
Response: Yes,
s'agissant
I
de votre état mental.
Have.
Réponse:
question,
oui, effectivement.
Why did you
question.
Meet the doctor?
Pourquoi êtes-vous allé voir un médecin?
Response.
Réponse.
I met the psychiatrist
je suis
because
allé consulter
before
auprès d'un
these
psychiatre.
Hearings,
parce qu'avant ces
I was told that
on m'a
there were psychiatrists, there are psychiatrists at the TPO organization who would be ready to give us
TPO
the assistance.
Qui pourraient
and then I contacted them
et je les ai
and paid them a visit.
Et j'aurais rendu visite.
Mr. Kung Pisai, thank you
question,
very
vous
much, Madame Chhin Navi, but I have
Madame
another
Navi,
question, but not to Chhin Navi, to the accused
poser.
This time.
Je souhaiterais poser une
the
question
President,
à l'accusé,
le
Président.
You may proceed with your question to the accused, and the accused is now instructed to listen to the question to the civil party lawyer. And the accused is reminded that you can exercise your right to remain silent if you so wish.
Thank you,
says Hong Kong Pisai.
S'il ne souhaite pas répondre à la question posée.
First question. After
question.
Consultation with Chinavi,
après
she would like
Madame
to put this
Chinavi.
Question through the lawyer to the
elle
accused whether he knows
poser
the
une
arrest
question
of
pour
Mr.
Si elle
Thie Hau Tuck and whether he knows that
Thie si Hau Tuck
was tortured or not.
Ce qui s'était passé avec, avec le mari de la partie civile, si l'accusé a d'autres informations et s'il a été torturé.
The accused, as I understood, there are two questions.
J'ai cru comprendre qu'il y avait deux questions.
I would like to now respond to the first
je commencerai
one.
Par la première.
I don't remember
je ne me souviens pas.
When I was the chairman of S21, or maybe when I was the deputy chairman of S21 that Tihau Tuck was arrested and sent to S21. I have no idea.
Que ce soit à l'époque où j'étais directeur ou à l'époque où j'étais directeur adjoint de S21.
The civil party application of Madame Chinnawi was the third civil party application, followed by those of Chumay and Bumeng. I have compared these applications. I knew Bumeng and Chumay. And I also reviewed Chinnawi's application against the former list of the prisoners, which contained 390 pages. Then I spotted the list and I started to acknowledge that Mr. Tia Hao Tech was genuinely arrested and sent to S21 and later on executed. I do not deny this.
Je ne le nie donc
because
pas.
There has been documents,
documents
supporting my recognition. And having reviewed the application of Madame Chinnawi, it is very clear that Tia Hao Tech was working as the deputy chief of the civil aviation, and I started to realize that obviously Madame Chinnawi was the wife of Tia Hao Tuck. So in conclusion, I recognize that Tia Hao Tuck was really detained at the facility, but I have no idea when he, or whether he was there when I was as the chairman, because I had no idea whether I remember having seen him there.
De l'avoir vu.
President, next, we would like to give the floor to the co-prosecutors to put question to the civil party, if they so wish.
Pour qu'ils posent question
could the prosecutors be reminded or about how questions should be put to the civil party? Because she is here as a civil party, not a witness, and we believe that the questions should be framed in the name of the witness, the civil party rather than the witness. Co-prosecutor, thank you, Mr. President. Good afternoon, Mrs. Chinnawi.
Madame Chinnawi.
Did you ever share the information of the death of Mr. T. Hao Tuck with your children, and what would they react if you did so?
Et quelle a été ou quelle serait leur réaction?
Réponse. I found the photo of my husband and the list.
J'ai retrouvé la photo de mon mari et la liste de prisonniers à Tulsling.
And I shared them with children who cried out loud all over the house.
Le résultat de mes recherches à mes enfants,
they
qui
could
se sont
not
mis à
stop
pleurer
crying.
Et ne pouvaient s'arrêter de pleurer.
And they were so desperate because they knew that
leur chagrin
father died. They could no longer have any father to call daddy again. No one
que plus jamais il
ever took
qui
them to the
papa.
Airport
que jamais personne
where their father once worked at.
Ne les emmènerait à l'aéroport où travaillait leur père
and,
jadis.
And since I had to work hard to raise the children, and to put them
enfants,
in ministries, and then what would be the result of working that hard? And after all, my husband died and their father perished. And my Alors, children,
quel est le résultat de tout cela si leur père
the daughter actually, the youngest daughter conducted further research to find out more information about her father.
Pour compléter les informations
and I am busy and I could not really find out further about
j'étais
him.
Occupé, je n'avais pas le Prosecutor, temps de
thank you.
Are
they still in this kind of motion, I mean, to having learned that their father died?
Éprouve toujours cette émotion aujourd'hui?
Response.
Réponse.
Every one of them has shown their reaction. However, they are well disciplined at work.
Réagi, mais my au travail, ils font preuve
son
de discipline.
This morning had a mission to Simria province.
Ce matin, mon fils est parti
he was
en province,
assigned
Simria,
by
mission.
The Ministry of Health and the hospital, and he is a busy person.
Pour l'hôpital, c'est donc quelqu'un d'occupé.
My daughter got married.
Ma fille s'est mariée.
To the American,
un Américain,
and that American actually came to propose the marriage right inside of my home.
Un Américain qui a fait sa demande de mariage.
And they are busy.
Chez
thank
moi.
You.
Et,
prosecutor, thank
occupé.
You, Madame Chenavi, Mr. President.
Merci,
I have
Madame
no
Chenavi,
further
Monsieur
questions.
Pas d'autres questions que je souhaiterais poser à la
Attendez,
Le président.
The President, next, we would like to give the floor to the defense counsel to put questions to the civil party, if they so wish.
Merci, Monsieur
Mr. Wu, thank you,
président.
Mr. President.
Merci, Madame, pour votre...
Thank you.
Déclaration.
For your statement as well.
La défense n'a pas de questions
The
à
defense
poser.
Has no questions to put to you.
Je vous remercie.
Thank you.
The President.
Le président.
Next, the chamber would like to give the floor to the accused.
Nous donnons maintenant la parole à l'accusé.
To make his observation. In response to the statement made by
the
civil party, if he so wish to do so. The accused.
L'accusé.
Mr. President, I do not have any
Monsieur
further
le
observation
Président,
to make at this
dire,
moment. Thank you,
stade,
Your
merci.
Honor. The President, Mrs. Chenavi, the proceedings in which we have heard your statement have already come to an end.
Votre déposition en tant que partie civile arrive ainsi à son
terme. Now
you
may go back to sit at the civil party reserved
Vous pouvez prendre place sur un des sièges réservés aux parties civiles.
Or you may choose to go home.
Vous rentrez chez vous si vous le souhaitez.
It's up to you.
Chia cách bản tỏ, bản trầy tỏ là cá, anh chơi lục tội một nâng.
The President, the court official is now instructed to call Mr. Tok Monin into the courtroom. The president, the civil party, is your name Tok Monin?
Le président, est-ce que vous appelez bien Tok Monin?
Response, Mr. President, my name is actually Tok Monin.
Oui, Monsieur le Président, je m'appelle bien Tok Monin.
Question, how old are you?
Quel âge avez-vous?
Response, I am 54 years old.
54 ans.
Question. Where were you born?
Où êtes-vous né?
Response.
Réponse.
I was born in Prekoi village, Prekoi commune, Kamie district, Kampong Cham.
Province de Kampong Cham.
At the in the former regime, Prekoi was called Swa Kaung.
Prekoi s'appelait Swa Kaung.
Question. So
question.
Where do you live? And what do you do for a living?
Actuellement, et quelle est votre profession?
Response.
Réponse.
I live in Very Lake, Swai Tiep, Chom Ka Le, Kampong Cham. I am a school teacher at Hun Sen School.
Enseignant à l'école Hun Sen.
President, what is your father's name?
Quel est le nom de votre père?
Réponse. His name is Tok Mi. My mother's name is
Mao Kon.
She is deceased.
Elle est décédée.
Question. How many brothers and sisters have you got? And please tell the court the names of those siblings.
Réponse.
I have 7 siblings. First,
Tok Simon,
Tok Bunthorn,
Tok
Sokon,
Tok Moni,
Tok Monin, I am,
Tok Monin, c'est moi-même,
Tok Sokhun, and
Tok
Sokom.
Et Tok Sokom.
Question. Mr. Tok Monin, is
Tu
Mien, Tu Ren, Tu Saren,
Tu Saren,
Prun, Mao Bun John or Bun Thon,
and
Chia Khan, your relatives? Or can you tell us about the kinship of these people in relation to you? Response. These names were the relatives of mine.
Sont ceux de parents à moi.
Tu Mien was my uncle.
Était un oncle.
Prun was the nephew-in-law.
Était.
Tu Saren was also nephew.
Était aussi un neveu.
And they all were relatives. Chia Khan was my cousin.
Était un cousin.
He was the last son of my auntie.
Le fils cadet de ma tante.
He had 6 siblings. Chia Pai, Chia Lai, Chia Pat, and he himself,
Chia Khan.
Chia Khan was my close cousin
était un cousin
because
proche.
His mother was the sister of Mao M.
Était la sœur de Mao M.
Question, what about the name Mao Bun Chon or Mao Bun Thon? What is his relationship to you? Response, Mao Bun Thon was my cousin on my mother's side, as his father was my mother's relative, and my other sister's name was also Tok Bun Thon.
J'ai une sœur qui s'appelait aussi Bun Thon.
The president, the chamber would like now to give the floor to the civil party lawyer for this civil party to make a brief presentation of the civil party's identity, the reasons to be joined as a civil party, and the relationships and the damages claimed by the civil party against the crimes alleged on the accused Kangayev Elis Duch regarding the facts at S21 during the decay period from the 17 April 75 to the 6 January 79, in addition to other relevant evidence to prove the application to be the civil party of this client. Hong Kong Soon, thank you, Mr. President, Your Honours, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Hong Kong Soon, the civil party's lawyer for this civil party, and Mr. Doge Monin is the civil party, and he is a Cambodian national with the ID 06017261 and 1, and the document EN number is 00211313232. And another document D25/14/1. Secondly, he joined as a civil party with the application document EAN number in the Khmer language 00021113221. That is the information formed for the victims.
De renseignements sur la victime.
The application was made as the cousin of Chia Khon alias Chhin,
cousin de
male,
Chikon, sexe masculin,
who was arrested on the 2nd of January 1977. This
Chia Khon
alias Chhin named was in the prisoners list of
S21.
In the document, the list of the S21 prisoners with the EAN number in the Khmer language 00161010 84, in the serial number 94 in English and Khmer, the name is Chia Khon alias Chhin, 35 years old, male engineer from Russia, arrested on the 2nd January 77, and a DC cam document which was part of the case file with EAN 00161073.
Nous avons aussi le document 00161063.
In another document with the EAN 00161 3 13 5 6 56, in the serial order 191, Chia Khon alias Chhin, engineer from Russia. Another document is a list of S21 prisoners with the EAN 00171 4 49. In the serial number 676, Chia Khon alias Chhin, engineer from Russia. And in that document, the information regarding the arrest and brought to S21 or to be smashed was only a question mark. Also, in the documents regarding the confession of Chikon, alias Chhin, was authenticated by the DC camp in the Khmer language ERN 00239024, and in the English language 00221113333. This document name is D25/14/2, which states regarding the documents maintained at the DC camp. Because I cannot find the year number for the document in the case file 001, I went to the museum of the Genocidal Museum and asked for the document, which was dated 1999. That's the documents that I submitted this morning, plus the other parties, are the authenticated documents maintained at the current Genocidal Museum. It's the confession of Chikon alias Chhin. In addition, I just received a photo of the victim Chikon alias Chhin. This is a photo taken prior to 1970. It was submitted through the relative of
Dok Monin.
And I would like to ask the accused in the end whether he knows this person. As this document,
il s'agit ici d'un document,
is a written document,
manuscrit,
with the president's leave, I would like the accused to verify who is or who was the interrogator. The name written was Paul, and there was an information regarding the farewell to Russia in 1965. The name was Kang Yu, so I'm not sure the accused can verify that information. The reason of the relationship between Tok Monin and the victim was that in the identification document on the mother's side, the surname was Mao Aim and the father was Ji Bu. The parents of Ji Gon, alias Chhin, was the cousin of the parents of Tok Monin, and they are cousins. The reasons for joining the application was that the direct blood relatives, that is the parents of that victim, died during the Khmer Rouge regime. That's why Tok Monin lodged a complaint in behalf of his relative as his cousin of Chikon alias Chhin. And next, I would like the president to allow the client Tok Monin to describe his events during the Khmer Rouge regime and his research and find the death of his cousin at the
S21.
The president, Mr. Tok Monin, the chamber would like now to give you the opportunity to make your statement before this chamber, the events the relationships to the crimes alleged on the accused, the damages inflicted upon you as a result of the Khmer Rouge democratic regime, as well as during the establishment and operation of the Security Office S21 from the 17 April 75 to the 6 January 79, and the physical or emotional or psychological damages that you received, and the direct impact or damages on you yourself up to the present time. You take the floor.
Monsieur
Monin. Thank you, Mr. President. Let me recall from the beginning regarding the history of my family and my cousin, Chikon alias Chen. This person was my cousin, the fifth child of my auntie Mao Aim. Mao Aim was the younger sibling in on my family side. My mother had five siblings: Mao Aim, Mao Um, Mao Un, Mao Hun, and then my mother, Mao Con, who was the youngest daughter amongst the siblings. Before 1970, my parents were a rice farmer living in Prekoi Sab district. My mother was the poorest amongst her family members. Before 1970, after the 18 March coup in 1970, my aunt family, Chibu and Mao Aim, had several children residing in Phnom Penh except Chipan, who was a peasant. Therefore, the event of the coup, after it happened, my family discussed amongst ourselves with her elder sister that the war will be broken out, because once the prince was toppled, the war would break out. And due to the fear of being bombarded, then my mother was convinced to live in Phnom Penh. In Phnom Penh, she would live with my elder sister, Chia Lai. And in Phnom Penh, the parents of Chia Lai and her husband Turan, who was a government official, took care of all the family members. And I myself was one of the people who was under that family, including my younger sister and younger brother. The three of us were in charge of their care. And my elder siblings went to work in the factory. My younger sister, later on, sacrificed her study and went to work as a factory worker. During that colonial regime, in order to get the money to feed ourselves. At that time, my mother had to have a surgery in that year. The living situation was deteriorating, and Chia Lai tried very hard to feed us, to look after us, as my parents were old and could not do anything else. At that time, I was only focusing on study. I studied at the Bangkok College. Every day, I spent my time studying and struggled together with my siblings to help with his work. Also with my cousin, I was given everything, including my schooling. The living in Phnom Penh at that time
pour que nous puissions faire nos études. À
he had a younger sibling, Mao Um,
mon cousin avait un frère ou une
sœur, whose father was Thu Sok. They were also in law. My family usually on my family side usually the cousins married one another.
Dans ma famille en général les cousins se mariaient entre eux.
After the 17 April 75, I lived with him until
Phnom Penh
fell.
Phnom Penh est tombé.
I was very worried.
J'étais très inquiet.
As my siblings lived separately, especially Turin. Turin actually supported me a lot as well. And Turin's parents lived together at the house of Jialai and Turin.
Avec Jialan et Turin.
Later on,
ensuite,
when we left Phnom Penh,
lorsque nous avons
after
quitté Phnom Penh,
the black-clad Pol Pot soldiers
après
who were adolescents forced us to move
de Pol Pot
out of Phnom Penh for 3 days, and if we refused, we would be bombarded. And the Angkor would not allow the bombardment, and we were worried.
Jours,
we didn't know what to do as
the
relatives lived apart. And next morning we were told again. So we had a gathering amongst ourselves and my aunt.
On nous a répété l'ordre et nous nous
and
sommes
we
réunis
agreed that we had to move,
décidé que nous
otherwise we would be
partir.
Punished. Therefore, in the late afternoon, we departed from Stulko, the quarter number 2, passing through
Tulsongkai
to kilometer number 6. That was the time when I thought of the regret that I did not bring enough belonging. I only carried books because I believed that we would return after 3 days.
Parce que je pensais qu'on
so I only brought books along. It was a case of book and a little bit of rice. We left together with my mother and my aunt.
Moi une caisse de livres.
When we reached kilometer number 6,
avec ma tante et avec ma mère,
and we saw people gathering around when the rice was distributed, so I went to request for the rice and we got like 10 kilos of rice for our big family. Along the journey, my aunt only carried her money, her currency. That was her saving, and I asked her to spend all the money in case the currency would not be used later on. But she insisted on keeping her money, and she did not believe that the country would be without any money or currency. When we reached Tamani
Pagoda
at Bunyelu, she realized that money was no longer traded, and that was the time my family sat opposite each other, speechless,
and
as we did not have any means of supporting ourselves.
De moyens de subvenir à nos besoins.
One day, along our journey,
un jour,
when it was at nightfall, we slept, and then I felt the bad odor. Then we found a shriveled corpse. Then we had to move to another location.
Nous avons trouvé
it was unfortunate
un cadavre,
that my family had to come across such a dead body and that we slept nearby a dead body.
Je pense que c'était tellement difficile d'avoir réalisé
it
que nous étions
sur
le point de nous endormir
river.
À côté d'un cadavre. Donc nous sommes allés dans
at that
dans
time,
Angkor
made an announcement that people
rivière,
were required to go to Badenburg if they wished to, and some decided to go to Kampong Cham. I myself, with my aunt and uncle, decided to return to our village because we had never been to Badenburg. So we took the ferry crossing the river, and then the announcement was made again. again who wish to go to Kampong Thom or Chum Ka Le, and we made our decision not to go there, and we requested to go to Chung Knok at the mountain, but we were denied as the road was blocked. So we had to take another road passing at the back of the mountain before we reached that location.
Avant d'arriver
at
cet endroit-là,
the Stung stream, we realized that we reached our village as we came from the other side.
Nous sommes arrivés en fait de l'autre
made a journey
côté
through the stream.
Et nous avons longé le cours d'eau.
The president,
le président,
Defense Council, François Roux, you take the
Maître
floor.
Maître Roux, je vous en prie, vous souhaitez intervenir.
Oui. Monsieur le Président, pardon d'interrompre, mais est-ce qu'on pourrait demander aux témoins, comme vous l'avez fait, de se recentrer sur les faits qui concernent S21 et le membre de sa famille qui l'a perdu S21. Tout ça sont des moments historiques importants, c'est vrai, mais ce n'est pas l'objet de la participation.
But this is not the purpose of the civil party.
So if you could
please re-invite the civil party to refocus his statement.
The president.
Le président.
The observation of the Defense Council is appropriate.
L'observation du Conseil de la Défense est pertinente.
Gives the floor again to the civil
avant
party,
que la Chambre ne redonne la parole à la partie civile,
I myself made it clear
je tiens
of the 11
à préciser
facts alleged on the accused,
que nous devons parler ici
that
que la partie
you
civile
received
doit parler
as a result of the establishment and
à nos débats.
Operation of S21 from the 17th April 75 to the 6th of January 79, which leads to you being joined as a civil party to this case.
Événements qui vous ont amené à vous constituer partie civile
and
dans
this
le cadre
is the
de ce procès.
Which are being put before
nous
the chamber. So, Mr. Civil Party, please focus only on the relevant part.
Nous vous invitons, Monsieur.
In relation to the facts and the accused, do you understand
sur
that?
Sur ces faits, vous comprenez bien ce que je viens de dire.
Yes, Mr. President.
La partie civile, oui, Monsieur le Président.
I would like to say that
je souhaiterais
if
dire
the President wants me to talk about the tool slide,
si
I would like to go back. The reason
slang, il va
that
que je
I lodge my complaint
la raison pour laquelle
as a civil party
partie civile
is on the behalf of my cousin, and that my cousin's families all died, only a few nephews survived, and the other grandmother and fathers, they were all traumatized. I was discouraged from lodging this application, but because I had a view of the democratic and fair process, that's why I made my decision to join as a civil party. My intention is to pay my gratitude to my cousin, Chikon alias Chun, who had great
alias Chun,
and kind sacrifice and help on my family.
Qui a aidé ma
famille. He went to study in Russia in 65 and in
75.
That is, 3 months after the fall of Phnom Penh,
he
returned
Phnom Penh,
to Cambodia.
And
my family did not know that he returned, even his parents did not know. We were all surprised. When our family arrived at our native village, Breikoi, then his in-law, Turen,
Pruen,
and a few other members of the family, and my uncle, Tusok, Turim, Turen, were all executed. Let me say they were all executed because they were called for re-education, but then people whispered that they died, and we heard this from the base people. They said that we, the family, our family, were the bourgeoisie, we were the rich from the city, and we would not be forgiven. And a few months later, my parents and my uncle were evacuated to Kampong Siem in Kampong Triem. First, they put in the Angkun Day Pagoda, and later on, they split us up and my family to Pol Village, my uncle to Pupal Village, and my other family was moved to another village. And that's when I lived at that location from the ends of 75 to 76.
À partir de fin 75 jusqu'en 76,
from what I was told, he arrived at Brekoi village, and when he learned that some of the family members were taken away and that his father was relocated to Trien in Kampong Siem sub-district, Kampong Cham, he went to look for his family. And to look for my family in Kampong Siem district, to Chamkale district. First, along the street, my uncle said, where should we at the Chamkale? When we at Promat Day in Swatip sub-district,
Nyep
asked us to stay there.
Nip and lui a demandé d'y rester.
Cousin decided et mon to stay cousin at Swatip
dans ce district.
We live in each of the family member lives in a separate house.
Nous étions tous séparés les uns des autres.
He met with the family members. In fact, he was asked to live at a medical office, but later on he was asked to live at the Chamkale, and his position at that time, he works at the water sluice gate. He was an architect for the water sluice gate and the dams and canals. He designed all those sluice gates.
D'irrigation.
And later on, he went to design the dam at the Kampong Mo called One January Dam. And that's all the reasons for our regret, as toward the end of 76, we lost contact with him.
C'est la raison pour laquelle nous avons perdu le contact avec
lui. We only discussed among ourselves to predict of his fate. We didn't know where he was taken. We only learned that he was taken to be re-educated. And after the event of 1979, after the fall,
I went to research at the Tulsline prison. Après les événements de 79,
in the beginning, I only saw an individual cell,
which was partitioned
with a brick, with a brick wall,
and
it housed former Prime Minister Hunnam, and I went to look at various other cells. I saw the torturing tools, bloodstains, and the stench of blood. I was fainted. I tried to look for his photograph, but I failed to locate it only later on, before 1990s. I found a book. It was called List of Traitors, and in that book, in the Chamkale, the name of Chiekhorn was mentioned. I was not sure whether he was the Chiekhorn, an engineer from Russia, but I was 90% sure he's my cousin.
And only at a later stage, qu'il s'agissait là de mon cousin.
That I received a document after my younger sister.
Après que Chielai,
the elder sister of Chiekhorn,
la grande sœur de Chiekhorn, était malade.
She moved from living in Chamkale to a school and then to Siem Reap.
Dans une école, puis à Siem Reap.
I received that book from another relative to Riem.
D'un autre
and we reviewed the book and we discussed the book.
And we
were thinking whether we should make a complaint regarding the information contained in that book.
À la suite des informations contenues dans ce livre.
We waited to hear for the information in relation to the civil party applications before the tribunal because we had to have ample evidence to support our party applications. Then, when we made a contact with the ad hoc organization employees, then we were reassured that with those documents, we of course can. Could proceed with the application. I was saddened and sorry for the loss of my brother, Giacon, who was an engineer returning from Russia and who was tortured and perished in the regime. And I would like to conclude it now. Thank you, Mr. President.
Mettre un terme à ma déposition.
The President, next, we would like to give the floor to the civil party lawyer group 4 to put questions to the civil party to seek further clarifications to support the civil party claim for reparation, if they so wish.
Demande de réparation de la partie civile, s'il le souhaite.
Mr. Hong Kum-soon, thank you, Mr. President.
Hong Kum-soon, je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président.
Your Honours, since it is already 4:30 p.m., do you think that the statement of Mr.
Deutmann
should be postponed to tomorrow's session, or should we proceed further? The President, would you wish to put a lot of questions?
If the questions
cannot be extended further than 5
p.m.,
then the Chamber wishes to conclude his statement and the questions to be put to him by this late afternoon. And according to our calculation, we already predicted that we would hold a meeting for 1 hour and a half this afternoon. However, we failed to actually follow that schedule. So could you please tell the court whether you have a lot of questions to be put to the
beaucoup de questions à poser
civil party.
À la partie
if so,
civile,
then we would adjourn the hearing now. But if not, then we can finish
si tel n'est pas le cas,
hearing the statement of the civil party by 5 p.m.
Mettre un terme it would be à la déposition
good
de la
if we can do so.
Ce
but
serait bien si
it's up to the civil party lawyers now, because next or tomorrow we going to hear some experts.
Car demain, des experts
and
vont
however, we really respect the position of the civil party
lawyer. Mr.
Hong
Kim-soon,
Mr. President, thank you.
Kim-soon,
I will make sure that I will be brief and that I would only put 3 or 5 questions to the civil party. The President,
à la partie
you
civile,
are allowed to do that.
Je vous en prie.
Mr. Kim-soon,
Maître Kim-soon,
Mr. Toymanen,
Monsieur Toymanen,
you already stated before the chamber, but we would like
vous
to seek some clarification because we have
récit.
Just obtained the photo
obtenir de votre
of Chhin.
Nous avons obtenu la photo de Chhin.
Where have you obtained this photo and how?
Où avez-vous obtenu cette photographie
and how
et de
did
quelle
you
manière?
Really establish the fact that it is genuinely the photo of Chhin?
La photographie représentant
response. This photo was taken seen in 1979 by because his auntie showed this photo because people were suspicious because they thought that Chiu Khan would die, and some would les say that he would not be dead. So that's why the auntie produced the photo to prove that, to show everyone who actually could shed light on the whereabouts of Chiu Khan. And then having seen the photo,
then
we started to search for the photo, the whereabout of Chiu Khan. Chia Lai actually was the auntie who showed this photo, but she died because I have remembered seeing the photo. That's why later on we could search for the photo and we located it. Mr. Hong Kong Soon, thank you. Could with the President Liu, this document or photo be put up on the projector? The President, the court official, is now instructed to put it on the screen.
Le Président, nous demandons à l'huissier de bien vouloir afficher cette photo à l'écran.
Thank you, Mr. President. Can I put this question to the accused whether he recognized this photo? The President, the accused, you can respond to this question if you would wish to do so.
Monsieur l'accusé, pouvez-vous répondre à cette question si vous le souhaitez?
The accused, I indicated that Chiu Khan was the friend of mine.
C'est un de mes
and
amis.
I, of course, know him very
Et
well.
Bien sûr, je le connais très bien.
That's all.
C'est tout.
Mr. Hong Kong Soon, I don't put further questions and it is already clear, but I would like to ask my client, since you have joined as a civil party on behalf of Chiu Khan, alias Chhin.
Car je voudrais poser une question à mon client parce que vous avez déjà.
Do you wish to seek civil reparations in person
avec votre cousin
on your own, or would you leave it to the lawyer to do?
Demander en vos propres noms réparation ou bien souhaitez-vous confier cette question
regarding
au,
the civil party claim for reparations, I would like to let
the
lawyer actually act on my behalf.
À mon avocat pour qu'il puisse agir en mon nom.
The counsel.
Maître Kimson.
I am sorry, Mr. President. I said that it would be my last question, but I have another last question.
Il me reste une autre question finale.
In 1965. You
en 65.
Saw off Chiu Khan alias Chhin when Chiu Khan was departing for Russia. Did the accused see him off? The President, the accused can now respond to Mr. Kumsun's question. The accused, I don't want to recall any detailed event, but I would like to reiterate that I was there to see him off to Russia. Counsel, thank you very much, the accused, and also Mr. Monin for the statement. The President, the Chamber would like to give the floor to the prosecutors to put questions to Mr. Tou Monin if they so wish.
La parole au co-procureur s'il souhaite poser des questions à Monsieur Tou Monin.
Co-prosecutor, thank you, Mr. President. The co-prosecutors do not have any questions to put to the civil party.
À la partie civile.
The President.
Le président.
It is now an opportunity for the defense counsel to put questions to the civil party.
Au conseil de la défense de poser des questions à la partie civile s'il le souhaite.
Mr. Casabot, thank you, Mr. President. The defense counsel does not have any questions to put to the civil party. The President.
Le président.
It is now time for the accused to make his observations in relation to the statement of Mr. Toukmonin.
Ses observations s'agissant de la déposition de Monsieur Toukmonin.
The accused, Mr. President.
L'accusé, Monsieur le Président.
I do not have any specific observation to add in relation to the case of Jia Khan.
S'agissant de du
The President, Mr. Toukmonin, the proceedings to hear your statement as a civil party today has come to an end. And as the civil party, you have the right to observe the proceedings
d'assister au débat
within the courtroom. Or you may choose to go home.
Vous pouvez choisir de regagner vos foyers,
you wish.
Si vous le souhaitez.
Please, I note that you would like to put questions.
Je remarque que vous souhaitez poser une question.
Civil party, I would like
civile,
to put only last question because time, due to time constraints, I had four further questions, but I only want to ask one question to the accused.
Juste poser une question à l'accusé.
The question is.
La question est la suivante.
When my brother was detained at
S21,
was he executed at S21 or at Chiang Ek? So far, we have not obtained any information in relation to the place where he was killed. Please feed us with this information. The President, the accused, can actually respond to this question if he would wish to do so.
S'il le souhaite, répondre à cette question.
The accused, Mr. President,
l'accusé.
I cannot really answer in short
je ne peux pas répondre de
because
manière brève à cette
I was not in close contact with this kind of task.
Avec ce type de tâche.
So far as I guess,
d'après ce que
it is more than 50% that Jia Khan would be executed at Chiang Ek. However, I do not really deny that he could have been smashed at Phnom Penh location.
Qui n'a pas pu être exécuté à la prison.
The President, the hearing
S21.
In which we heard the testimony or the statement of the civil party comes to an end, and the court is now adjourned. The session will be resumed tomorrow at 9 a.m.
Nous reprendrons l'audience
tomorrow. We are going to hear the statement of the expert as scheduled.
Le témoignage de l'expert, hein, et ce, selon
the
notre
security
programme.
Personnel are now instructed to take the accused to the detention facility and return him to the courtroom by 9 a.m.
D'ici 9
the court
demain
is
matin.
Adjourned.
L'audience est levée.